Malash has proven himself to be a dangerous leader.
Indeed. That's why my victory shall be the sweetest of ecstasy.
Has he defeated many in this rite?
Countless. He ascended the chain with brutal wrath, plowing through all who opposed him. It's as if he were blessed by the Dark God. They called him the Blade of Amon.
And still he was challenged?
It is our way. He defeated each with lingering cruelty. Malash revels in bringing his challengers to the edge of death and tormenting them for a time after.
That does not comfort me, Alarak.
Comfort is a myth. Given to younglings until they are ready for the trials and pain that is true existence. Leave me. It is time to make preparations.
The assault ships are now ready for your inspection.
Destruction is at hand.
This chain of ascension is a despicable practice.
It is how the Kalai once thought of the Narazim's Shadow Walk.
There is no comparison. Our society was not founded upon...
Their culture is one unyielding hierarchy. Servant to master. A constant reinforcement of their bondage to Amon. But they have been lied to, Matriarch.
And how could this change if it is all they have ever known?
Our people once only knew hatred of one another. Suspicion.
Yes.
We viewed your practices as barbaric, and you viewed ours as cruel. It is the same with the Tal Darim, with the destruction of Amon, and the revelation of his betrayal. I expect their entire society to seek out who they truly are and what they wish to be. Kerax, the Keystone, it's
reacting. To void energies upon the planet's surface, most likely. I've seen this before on Ulnar. This Terrazine must be directly linked to the void.
The Tal Darim call it the Breath of Creation. They believe imbibing it allows them to speak directly to Amon.
A far-fetched claim, yet I cannot deny its plausibility. The substance's properties appear to be foreign to our universe.
Perhaps this is why it is so holy to them. They seek out planets rich in Terrazine, and turn them into temples to their god.
Our coming here may be a blessing to us. If the Keystone reacts to Terrazine like it does with void energy, I may be able to use it to stress the artifact, determine its limits.
Perhaps fate has not abandoned us completely. We must have faith.
I prefer results, Hierarch. Amon is powerful in measures that eclipse even the Queen of Blades. There is no room for uncertainty.
I cannot bring myself to hope for Alarak's victory, but I also cannot hope for his defeat.
The hour of my ascendance. Let Rak'Shir commence!
The rite of Rak'Shir has begun. From this moment, only Alarak and Malash are allowed to engage each other in combat directly. One must overpower the other and reach the pit of sacrifice. There, the victor will stand as the new leader of the Tal'Darim, and the loser's life will be forfeit.
They appear quite evenly matched.
This is true. However, from what I have learned, Rak'Shir allows the champion's supplicants to support them psionically. Our warriors will be able to aid Alarak. But likewise, the Tal'Darim can assist Malash.
I will ready our forces. Malash will fight ruthlessly to hold on to his power. We must be prepared to do the same.
Shortly. We should ensure Alarak has sufficient reinforcements.
Malash is drawing power from the Tal'Darim. Alarak will need the support of our warriors.
Your psionic power courses through me. Move forward, slaves! Kill all who aid Malash!
You would do well to remember that I command these warriors, Alarak, not you.
I don't understand how this is possible, but my scanners are detecting high solarite concentrations in the native beasts here.
We ought to pursue them. However, I think it best if we don't inform Alarak of this little diversion.
Understood, Hierarch.
Thank you. forces inbound on our nexus point.
Brothers, attack the Firstborn directly.
Sensing hybrid. They come to aid Malash.
Aemon's harbingers, join our struggle. Fight well, warriors, and you will also ascend into hybrid.
Oh, you lie with such conviction. It is almost admirable. My vengeance will not be delayed. Send me your warriors.
hybrid approaching. Be ready.
The shadow of death. Only destruction awaits our foe.
Dominator has appeared. It is on its way to Malash.
Well done, warriors. The first beast has been slain.
Thank you.
death fleet descends. I am the Emperor. For prudence.
Locking on to the beast's coordinates, warping it aboard.
A hybrid behemoth. Be wary, Artanis.
Your will.
Unusual digestive system.
Are you saying that they're
late. Never mind. I do not wish to know.
Malash grows stronger. Slay his Calderine quickly.
Descends. Only destruction himself.
already won. You were right about one thing, Malash. I will lead them. By the right of Rak'Shir, I am your High Lord. Listen and obey. Malash promised you lies. There is no ascension. The Tal'Darim will never be uplifted and become hybrid. Amon betrayed us, and for this, he must die.
Cause, as you do.
What they believe is of little consequence. What matters is that they obey.
You choose to rule differently than I, Alarak. Despite this, we may not only end the violence between our kind, but forge a powerful alliance.
Can we now? My people are vastly different than yours, Hierarch.
We both desire vengeance, and we are both Protoss. Is that not enough?
Very well. Submit to my absolute authority, and we may indeed unite our forces.
Do not test me, Tal'Darim. Amon is a mighty foe. Your people cannot hope to stand alone against him. You will side with me, and together we will send him back to the Abyss.
So you do understand my culture after all. Let us say that for now, we have struck another bargain.
Hierarch, I have powered up a new ship subsystem. You can review it in the solar core now.